some kind of
I don't know about this movie.
Ron, get yourself out
Come on, George. Where's the movie held now?
Ron,
Find that Ken Chai character.
Ron, I have some unfortunate news. I'm afraid I really have to poopy at this particular juncture.
Well, I could go to the Duker as well.
Let's go. Let's see if we can
I guess we'll postpone that little movie, Ken Chai.
We'll find it later. Ken Chai is a fine individual.
He's an Oberlin College student.
Well, yes.
I'm told they're intellectual.
That's what I hear. Whoa, Ron, I'm afraid I really have to poop at this point.
Okay, George.
Well, Ron, really have to drop a load at this point. Which one would you prefer here?
Well, there's only two, George. It's not like at the White House. I think I'll take this one over here.
Wait a minute. Gotta do it with your time correctly aligned. You're not looking stylish at this
point. Neither are you, George. I wouldn't talk.
All right, now let's poop.
Okay. Let's go, Duke.
There's not much room in here.
These things are not very safe, are they?
Afraid I have to stand in the toilet. Not prudent at all.
Don't forget to take off your coat, George. Last time you had an accident, it was really disturbing in the press room. No, I'm having a hard time.
Well, Ron, now. It's one of nature's wondrous functions.
Well, George, I'd like to go poopy.
Well?
I can't seem to find my...
I'm having a hard time here, George. I usually don't do this without the assistance of Barbara.
You know, Nancy once said to me, you are an old fart. And now I have to do one. Oh, it's cold in here, George.
It is cold. Should have checked the windows before we did. Would have been particularly prudent.
George, I'm going to the bathroom. Will you shut up?
Here, I'll join in.
We're going to have to edit, I think. George?
What?
Who's this Vanilla Ice Biscuits character I keep hearing about?
I don't know, but he had some kind of accident with his eyebrows, it seems.
Well, he's in some new video, and he's calling it OC Baby, and I think that's why we're here.
Oh,
evidently,
Mr. Ice, well, I talked on the phone to Mr. Ice Biscuits on Thursday. Quite a fine, upstanding individual. Typical American youth. He was just a fine, upstanding person.
George?
Yes? Great to have
you. I'm told we're to see a movie here, George.
Well, Ron, have to complete some paperwork before we do that. Seems prudent at this particular juncture.
Our paperwork is very prudent, you're right, Tim. And you use that word sparingly.
Yeah. Oh. Not used to doing this without Barbara. How is Nancy these days?
Yeah. I wouldn't know. I think Nicaragua is closer to Texas than Nancy Reagan is to me.
Well, that's not prudent. Right, I don't have quite enough room in here to do the job that needs to be done.
I don't know anything about room. My stall's quite spacious. I can even spread my legs if I really want to. Watch out.
No.
Oh, I seem to have broken the toilet here, George.
No, Ron.
Will?
Not like you.
Will, I broke the toilet. I'm going to try to dress myself.
Ron.
I hope I didn't disturb anyone by breaking the toilet. Oh? George, I think you have to come over here.
Well, hang on there, Ron.
George, I broke the john. George, will you take a look at this?
Ron?
George, that Ken Chai character is not going to enjoy this.
Excuse me, Ron?
George?
I am in the process of zipping up my fly.
George, I broke the john, George.
Okay, Ron, hold on.
I'm trying to get out of here. This metalless jacket. Oh, George, look at this.
Ron, what have you done now?
Well, I don't know. I don't know, George. It just broke. Oh, well, I better flush, however.
For heaven's sake.
I better flush the toilet, George.
George,
I broke the john. I don't know.
Oh, no.
Oh,
not well.
Let's just leave it, like we do at the White House. If we do something wrong, let's just leave it alone. Come on, George.
Ron, as is so like you, you have done it once again.
Oh, George.
Well, I think we'll just leave it here.
Okay.
Let's go find that Mr. Chai.
Well,
he seems like such a nice man. I think we'll talk to him about this problem.
We'll blame it on on some lower class scum out there.
Yeah, that sounds
There's
good.
There's so many of them.
Sounds good.
Okay, okay, let's go find this
Seems
wonderful
prudent.
Movie.
Seems prudent. Let's do it.
Come on, George.
Hanging out on my line.
Zip it up there, George.
Okay, we're zipped. Let's go, Ron.
George, I broke the John. I don't know what to do
well,
about that.
Now, Ron, you did a lot of bad things in the course of your 8 years.
Well,
you just
I
need to
know.
Forget about them and move on.
Now, let's move on.
That's the American way.
I'm told
That's what
that
Nancy would want you to do. It
George,
would be prudent at this particular
George,
John.
George,
sure,
I'm told Hans and Franz are in this movie, George. Do you know Hans and Franz?
I do like them a lot. Fine, up to... Whoa, well,
George,
damn it,
watch yourself.
Got killed by the door. Where are the Secret Service?
Secret Service men, where are you?
Well, oh, George, I think we're missing the elevator.
Now we get... We have to push the button, push the George.
Get in there, George. I'm going to
go first. This time.
I'm going to go first, George. Come on, come on. You
country needs me more than it needs you at this point.
Things. One, two, or three. I'm going to go up here.
Three.
Oh, I don't understand.
Now, what is... Hold on.
Don't hit that, George. George!
Oh, no.
George, I think you've released a Scud missile.
Well...
Not prudent, George.
Sorry, Ron.
Come along.
No, after you, Ron.
I'm afraid it fell on you last time.
Well, hold on a minute.
I already broke one door here.
Wait,
watch out now. Oh, my God.
Oh, no. Push it.
Let's make a run for it, George. Come on.
Run.
Okay. Well, all right. Well, we're going to go in this lounge, I think.
You shouldn't have taken this trip
way.
Without Nancy and,
I don't know your wife, do I?
What's her name?
Your wife's name?
She looks like my mother. I like her a lot.
I don't know.
Raisa? No, after you.
Oh, Ron. Oh, you're George. I'm Ron. Okay, let's watch this film. Okay.
Down. Hey. spend all your nights by yourself? That can change. Call me, Candy, at 1-900-HOT-LOVE. I'm waiting. Don't be shy. We'll have fun.
Thanks, Candy. If you want some real steamy conversation, call me, Bunny. I'm into fast cars, stingers, and nachos. Just call 1-900-HOT-LOVE. I'll be waiting. Are you ready?
Hi, I'm Bobby. I was spending another lonely evening by myself, eating a big bowl of cereal with icy cold milk, when I saw Bunny and Candy on the 1-900-HOT-LOVE commercial, so I decided to call them. Since then, my hormones have never been the same, and neither has my phone bill. Oh, by the way, you don't have to be 18 to call. I'm only 14.
1-900-HOT-LOVE, 95 cents for the first minute, $20 each additional minute. Sponsored by the Talk How You Like Posse.
Ken left me alone with the camera. Made a real big mistake. I'll go around and film people. People in Phillip's gym. Like this fellow.
How you doing?
How you doing?
I'm very excited right now. I'm reading On the Road by Jack Kerouac.
Let me see that. Yep, that sure is what it is.
It is what it is. And the lights are bright. And it's night. It's fun.
How much are you getting paid?
About $4.35 or something. Slow and
something
small.
Low and small and minuscule.
Minuscule.
Let's check this person out.
Hey,
you know what the war on and all, you should really frisk these people.
Yeah,
especially this woman.
Yeah, especially me.
We'll take a look. Well, I don't see anything on her.
Hey, did I let you in?
Yeah, you can even add it to the
table.
That's okay. We got her on film. She's
thanks
got anything.
For, thanks for reminding me.
Let's take a look upstairs.
Have fun.
I can't fail to have fun.
No, there's some restricted security around the office.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah?
Can I go in there and get a key?
Just keep knocking the door or something.
All right. Tremendous view. Phillip's gym. There's the door. I feel like a security guard. Let's take a look down here. Taking a tour of the tremendous complex built by the ancient Egyptians in 74 BC. That wasn't funny. Big hallway here. Getting seasick. Let's see people here. Anybody know him? Do with this video. Hey, there's somebody I know.
Hey, how's it going?
All right, how are you?
Good. Is that for Ken?
For Ken who?
For Ken, my next door neighbor, Ken?
Oh, he died.
Oh my God, I'm so sorry.
Yeah, he gave me his camera.
Oh yeah?
Don't be sorry.
Well, I'm not that
look what
sorry.
I got, man. There's stuff for you, too.
Really?
Stop by the room.
Can I have a stereo?
Stop by the room.
Oh yeah? Well, I'll stop by when I get home.
Pardon?
I'll stop by when I get home.
All right.
You know?
All right, what are you up to?
You talk to Ken's family? tell them?
No, they're out for their ear analysis.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, when they finish urinating, tell them that I'm kind of sorry about Ken, but he's got a great turntable, and I thank them for that.
Well, they understand.
Yeah. So,
okay.
Take it easy.
All right. Well, it's one of those times. Ah, thank God. Here, quick. I don't think I can hold it any longer. I don't think I should film this, do I? Do we film stuff like this? How many women out there have never seen one of these? How many have but don't know what to do with it? How many think this is really stupid film? I should close it right here. You know, there's a lot of weird things in the bathroom. How about those hieroglyphs on the wall? How many people have seen this one? What the heck is that supposed to mean? Now, how about this one? Who are these people and how can I vote for this dude? Nitro. Who are these people? I hate people. Don't forget the flush. Conserving water. Two sides to every story, yin and yang. Yeah, you're on. There she goes. Camera shot. She used to be a go-go dancer in Detroit. I knew her. Oh, she's coming for more. How you doing? How's the popcorn tonight?
Good.
What are you doing in the gym tonight?
Basketball.
What basketball?
What basketball?
Yeah.
The tournament.
The OB Olympics?
Yeah.
All right, I'm gonna go down and film that. How's that?
Okay.
All right. Should know better than to leave me this thing. Boredom sets in too soon.
Oh, there it is. Can't really focus too well because it's glass. Dummy.
Uh-oh. Huh. Never been up here. Anybody mind? Oh, Christ, I got caught. You're some idiot. Hey, weren't you drunk last night?
What?
Weren't you drunk and passed out somewhere? Weren't you drunk and passed out somewhere the other night?
Tell us about that girl that you were fooling around with.
Hey, man, don't tell nobody, all right? Listen, what are you up to tonight? Hey, don't do that, man. Hey, don't do that. That ain't cool, man. I just say couscous. Dude, what are you doing, man? What are you doing that to me, man? You're wasting film. What's going on?
Ping pong tournament. You, the OB Olympics.
You're in the ping pong?
Yeah.
Man, your face is big right now. Let me go back a little bit.
Thanks, I appreciate that.
What are you doing up here, man? Ping pong's downstairs.
I'm in. I'm going to
the... How are your biscuits, man? Turn around real quick. Let's see. Oh, man, that's sore. Tender. Ripe. Give me four, please, to go. Uh-oh. Kids. Oh, look. How you doing tonight?
Good. How you doing?
All right. What are you here for?
Workout.
Oh, yeah? And these are kids?
Yeah.
Is that a Cabbage Patch Kid?
No.
What is it?
Come on, thank you.
Her name's what?
Karen.
Oh, that's cute. That's a cute doll.
Come on, you guys.
How you going?
Have a good time tonight in the gym.
Thank you. Wait a second. I want to ask a question.
The kid's going to grow up to be a world-class sprinter. Mention film star and drug lord. All right, here we go.
Oh, man.
Come on, buddy. I'm following you. What are you doing in there anyway? Uh-oh, buddy, you're asking for it if you go in there. I have no shame.
Hey, get out of here.
What are you doing, man? You don't have... Oh!
Sorry.
break.
Alright, buddy. It's time to go film something real. I'm wasting up too much space here.
You are wasting way too much film.
So what, man? I'm gonna go down to film now for real.
See ya.
See? As if this was...
It's time for North Hall's most embarrassing moments, where you act like a turd and we film you and show all your friends. Okay, really, we should support our embarrassed residents, but this is a comic, not serious film, created over winter term, and we don't want to be nice and boring. So laugh at these idiots. They're a lot like you and me. But if you are really offended, I suggest you talk to Ken Chi at 5883. It was all his fault.
Edit that last one.
Hey, what's your name?
Holly.
Where are you from?
Near San Francisco.
Ah, so did you drive out here or fly?
We flew. I want water.
What's the strangest thing you've ever done in your life?
I told you it was coming.
I don't know. I've done many strange things.
The strangest?
I don't know.
Oh.
You don't know?
I know something.
Biscuits.
Oh, of course.
Well, that's really
But, listen, Scott, I'm not going to be around much longer.
That's all right. I don't think it's anything really important.
Yeah.
If you could,
it was.
Yeah, if you, like, have me in there and, like, one pick up to do a game,
I
want
you
to come
and get it, whatever it is. Yeah, you and Bill and Terry have stuff in the closet of mine. I don't know who's in. I see those right there.
This is the effect.
Hey, Mark? Mark, you all right? Mark, listen to me. This is Mike.
Mike, cool.
Get me some, like, toilet paper.
Toilet paper?
And a lot of it. Mark, I'm gonna lie you back, okay? Mark, did you fall? Do you know what happens?
Mom?
Did you fall, Mark?
Mom?
Mark, do you know who I am? Just stay still, Mark. Do you know who I am? Can you feel me back here? What I want you to do is go call an ambulance.
That feels good.
Do you feel my hand back there? Do you feel my hand?
Hand.
Yeah. Yeah. You all right, Mark?
Can you only, like, CPR or something? It's like,
don't worry.
Is
don't
he breathing
now? You okay, Mark?
Where's my beer?
You're fine, Mark. Just don't worry.
Where's everybody else?
Where's...
You feel my hand there? Where's my hand? Can you tell me where my hand is? Can you tell me where my hand is, Mark? Where's my hand?
On my head.
On what part of your head?
My lower part.
Okay. Where's my hand right now? Mark, where's my hand right now?
On my back.
Can you feel it right there?
Okay,
where's my hand right now?
On my hair.
Okay.
Oh,
where is it now?
Head hurts.
Your head hurts.
Mm-hmm.
Where does it hurt, Mark?
All over.
It hurts all over? Mm-hmm. That hurt right in there?
Where's my beer?
Hey, Mark, calm down. Just calm down, Mark. Is it hurting there?
Mm-hmm.
It hurts in there.
A little bit.
Okay, Mark, what I'm going to do is I'm going to roll you on your back, okay?
Back.
I'm going to put you on your back, okay? You ready? Rolling you on your back right now. There you go. Okay.
Let's do that again.
No, we're not going to do that again. You feel my hand now, Mark? You know what day of the week it is?
Party.
It's party day. Do you know what day that is?
Friday.
Okay, it's Friday. All right. Do you know where you are?
I'm at Oberlin for winter term.
Okay, that's good, Mark. I'm glad. Take a deep breath, Mark. All right, that was good. You tell me if I hurt anything, okay, Mark?
Oh.
Is that hurting there?
Is this our first date? Oh.
This is our first date. Where's my hand right now?
On my hand.
Can you squeeze my hand? All right, good job. Can you squeeze this hand, Mark?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Where sure is everybody? No, are we playing quarters?
Mark, just lying back down. Your head still hurt? Okay.
Woo!
Does it hurt down there?
Oh.
Yo, can I have some help over here?
Is that
he
Damon?
Gave me, like, something to clean his face up.
Damon, where's the mad dog?
It's like a lot of tissue paper or something. Get him cleaned up.
Mark, you alright?
Now, dude.
What do you need?
Tissue paper.
Hey, Mark, are you alright?
Mm-hmm.
What do you need tissue paper for?
Clean his fucking face up.
But you know what? That throat looks familiar.
Hey, Mark, how do you feel now?
You know, I was looking in my refrigerator.
Come on, Mike, you fucking
like
knew. You didn't know? I told you down there.
You didn't tell me.
I told you already. I told you down there.
You really freaked me out for a sec. And after I gave you food
to make this.
You didn't know?
I had no idea.
What do you think I was doing hiding in your room the whole time?
I had no idea, dude.
You drinking that beer? Hey, don't drink that. It's bad for you. You hear me? Hey, you punk! You little snotty punky whippersnapper kid these days. All these kids these days. I'm one of those old people who doesn't like people who drink and takes too long at the bank and drives too slow in the speeding lane and wears a sweater, even if it's in the summertime, and carries an umbrella, even if it ain't raining, and complains all the time, and can't read small print, and hasn't had sex in 60 years, and doesn't care about what I eat, that's for sure.
Gee, I wish that old man will just fall down the stairs.
Oh my God. star medallion you are wearing right now.
Are you serious?
I am. How do you feel about the Persian Gulf, Dwayne?
I think it sucks, man. I hope I don't go over there. I got a knee injury, and I'm expecting to get out pretty soon.
All right. How can you dance here without Seth Peterson, my roommate here, over winter term?
Well, you know, I'm working tonight, and you know, I don't do too much dancing when I'm working, you know, because like the beer has been cut off to me personally because I drink too much of it.
That's true. You do drink too much, Dwayne. I've seen it happen. It's not funny.
It's something's got to be stopped. It's got to be stopped right now. I think it's a good time for it to happen. You know, my last semester here, I think.
Your last semester here, Dwayne?
I hope so.
Woo! All right, some people having fun. Here's a couple of newlyweds right here. Whoa!
Whoa!
Hey. All right, good to hear from you. All right, good. Hey, Eric, how you doing? Joe, good to see you again. Again and again. How you doing tonight?
Great, thanks.
All right, he missed you. Come on, Rush, you're not getting the stuff on film. You got to get me on film here. Here's Glenn again. We already talked to him again, but he's a favorite on Gutfest. Somebody just grabbed. How you feel about the Persian Gulf?
The Persian Gulf?
What Persian Gulf?
It's in my crotch, baby.
Oh, yeah, baby. How can you dance here without Seth Peterson being here?
I don't know. I really don't know.
You miss him is what you're trying to say.
He was in my pants last semester. I miss him really bad.
All right. Have a good time, man. All right. Good. Here we are, Ronnie Chi. Ronnie, how do you feel about your brother being up there in the skull?
I feel great.
Don't you love your brother so much?
Yeah, he's a
how
great
can you
teammate.
Dance with, how can you dance without Seth Peterson here?
I don't know. Because he's not here.
But don't you miss him?
Oh, yeah.
How you doing tonight?
Pretty good.
How can you dance without Seth being here?
Seth?
Oh,
sorry.
Seth Peterson.
I don't know.
Oh, my.
I really quit. So am I. Hi, this is fun.
All right. How do you feel about that Persian Gulf crisis?
Well, we're going to lose if we go, and the whole thing's stupid, and it's all a scam. Bush is full of shit. That's how I feel.
All right. Well, how do you like your years here at Oberlin College?
My years have been great. I'm filled with love for this fine institution.
Good for you. Have a good time at the SCO tonight. Get that live right here, touching my hair out at the SCO. Ken Chi is the man of the hour. Best DJ I've ever seen here at the SCO, and best DJ I've heard had been at the SCO for the past 17 years, according to Chris Baymiller, manager of the Dionysus. Here he is right now mixing some records. I'm told he has his own equipment there and he practices nightly, 2 hours a night at least. And he uses a lot of Ovaltine to stay up. Chocolate milk mix. Ken Chi misses Missy a lot. Missy's gone this winter term. Here we go with Delight. Groove is in the heart. From Ken Chi. Ken, what can you tell me about your years of DJing at the SCO?
Yes.
All right, there you have it from Ken Chi. A couple of syllables from him, man. He's very busy. We should get out of his way, but we're not going to. We're going to mess him up. And now we got a lot of people dancing out there. I hope Ross is getting all that on film. Interview, dancing, having a good time without Seth Peterson. Can you believe it?
I am bigger than you, Hans.
I'm bigger.
Welcome to Hans and Franz Pump It Hour.
I am Hans.
And I am Franz. And we
and
are here
to pump
you up. Come on, with us now as we journey through Philips Gym.
If you are not too much of a girly girl to party.
Look at our first partner over here.
Man workout.
Look at him. He's small and puny, but one day he will be big and hard and big pumpitude like us.
Name, young man?
What is your name?
Tom.
Yell it like a man, come on.
Tom!
Tom is going to be big and strong someday. I can just tell. Look at him. Yeah, he is Tom. Big and hard, Tom.
Oh, you are
breaking hands.
You are American.
You are big and hard. I like Tom. Tom is big and hard. I like him.
Tom, you have utter having potential. One day you will be big and strong, but you must to pump it every day. Pump it hard.
He must pump it harder, mustn't he?
Yes.
I don't like you. I like to eat.
He will be big and hard someday, but maybe not the brightest kid in the world. Okay. Now we must pump it harder. Oh,
you can
Goodbye, Tom.
Autograph later.
Have a good life and pump it. I don't know about that Tom. He doesn't seem to be pumping it hard.
He appreciated our pump it.
He must come home and do his homework or something. He doesn't pump it hard like us.
Yeah.
Let's go pump it.
Beginning our workout. And you shall follow us to learn how to become big, strong Czechoslovakian
big,
man.
Hard and strong.
Yeah.
The battery's running out, Ken. What are we to do?
Tell him, Franz.
We must pump it.
Pump it harder.
Come in here. We will pump it hard. Look. Look at all the people pumping it hard in here. Hans and Franz likes it. Look, Angela O working here. Hans, talk to Angela.
Yeah, Angela. What is it that you like about man with pompitude?
Huh?
Angela, you must love my big muscles, don't you?
She's admiring our pompitude.
You are impressed by my bigness.
She is helpless.
Look at that puny little man over there.
See how the American women admire my musculature.
Feel that again, Angela. Feel it harder. She loves me. She wants to mate. I can tell by the scent.
It's true.
Yeah. Come on, but we must go to the workout. Enough of the girly girls.
Let's go. Pump it. The Phillips Gym workout station for pump it hour. Hello, kids. Pump it harder. Hans and Franz love you all. Get water, you little girly freak.
No, I must have water so I should be at my maximum comfort.
No, you don't know anything. Is this thing rolling? Come on, let's all get pumped. Let's put lots of weight on the machines and act like we can lift a lot. I mean really lift a lot, because we are big and hard.
Franz, look at these girly men. They cannot...
They can't do anything near what we can do.
They cannot compare to...
We are so big and hard. We will dominate the world someday.
If Arnold Schwarzenegger was here, I'd crush him.
You are the biggest man I've ever seen besides myself, Hans.
I have to say that you are quite beautiful, Franz.
Let's lift 500 pounds now. Cut the film. Friend Hans is now putting tons of weight onto the barbell. Tons of weight for any ordinary man, but only a minuscule nothing for him.
This is a fraction of what I do in Munich at the Olympics. I take the gold home to Czechoslovakia.
And I taught him everything he knows, but he doesn't know anything. Isn't that amazing?
Yeah.
Pump a tube, put more weight on.
Yeah.
We taught Seth Peterson how to lift too, and now he is getting big like us. If you see him, mate with him. Put more weight on, little girl. 800 pounds at least we want. That's good.
Yeah.
Now let's lift it.
With one. Now we are here to the bench pressing part of the workout. We'll become the manly man before your very eyes.
Hans is going to lift for you 987.6 pounds, the most ever by a human being.
Ah, this is nothing. In Munich, I do four times this weight.
He is huger than everyone, and I taught him everything he knows.
Yeah, but I know nothing.
He's stupid and big.
Yeah, but we are to pump.
Pump?
You up.
Now watch him bench. Get prepared, Hans. Do your sexercises. Everyone wants to mate with you in the whole world. You are the perfect human besides me, that is.
If Arnold Schwarzenegger was here, I'd crush him.
He will too. Pump it, Mark. Pump it harder. Pump it now.
One, two, three, pump.
Look at him pumping it hard.
I pump it harder.
Look,
one hand, America.
Look how easy it is for the man to pump it.
To pump.
He moves his hands.
Problem.
He is banging himself in his own pumpitude. Hans, you did that so easily. How did you do it?
Because I am a manly man, not like you real girly girl Americans.
That's right. You are all little girly people. We will push down so you land in your own baby poo.
Yeah.
Pump it harder. Very good, Hans.
Yeah, thank you, Franz. I feel like manly man. And now you are two doing some pompitudes.
No, I am too big. I will break the weight. Multitude of pompitude weight on this barbell right now for the squat. My partner Hans did 900 pounds over there on the bench and some odd number. Now I am going to do about 2,000 pounds for the squat to prove that I am the biggest man in the whole world besides me.
Besides Hans.
You are a little girl, Hans.
No, you are a little girl, Franz.
Now we are fighting because we are big and strong.
But we are brothers and together our pompitude is so big.
I love you and I'd kiss you, but I'm too big.
There's no need to compete.
Thank you.
It's time for Franz to do. He's doing 2,500 pounds on his squat. But it is nothing for him because he is a manly man.
His muscles are so big they hurt in the night, crying out to be pumped.
Yeah, and now we're going to show that pompitude to you.
Let's do it now.
Yeah. It is nothing.
Yes, it is nothing. I will put it down because it is so easy to do.
It is so light for Franz.
All right. That was so easy to do, and I'm not even short of breath, even though I sound like it. Now we must pump it harder, but that's for another show. This concludes our time.
Do you not see how much bigger and stronger we are now?
We are bigger than anyone.
Workout.
Bigger than anyone, aren't we?
I remind you, if Arnold Schwarzenegger were here, I'd crush him.
He'd break his skull into little baby pieces.
Because he's a girly girl.
Yes. Believe me now or believe me later, we are huger than you.
And for the last time, it is Hans and Franz saying we want to pump. You up.
You up. Hans.
That woman was admiring our pompitude.
And Franz.
And we want to pump.
You up. Now let's get basketball and kick our cardiovascular back into shape.
After your anaerobic exercise, your pompitude, there's nothing better to do than some hoopatude.
Yes, hoopatude, let's go.
Observe as Franz does his 360 degree spiral dunkitude.
I will dunkitude later.
Yeah.
We need a basketball for to do hoopatude after our pompitude. It would be very funny. That is fine, even though it is only a woman's basketball. It will suffice for our hugeness.
Yeah.
Doubly. Take the ball, Hans.
Thank you.
Thank you much.
This ball is so small.
You could crush it. Because it's like you. You are huge. You are huge, Hans.
I am so big.
Calm down your hugitude. Let's go into the gym and show him how to pump it.
Yeah.
Michael Jordan doesn't know anything. Let's use our pompitude. Look at their farm. Come, we are ready to pump it up. Look at these little girly men. Now we need to use our hoopitude, Hans.
Franz, no one wants to play with us because they are so intimidated by our pompitude.
That's right. We are too big to play hoops with these little girly people. So we will find an open court for ourselves to show you all how great we are with the hoopster. We taught Michael Jordan how to play in 1982.
Yeah, Michael Jordan, when we find him, he not understand how to dribble the ball.
He just dribbled on himself.
Yeah.
We fixed him up with our huge pompitude.
It's not Wheaties. It's to work out like a manly man.
Let's go play hoops.
Yeah.
Look at these little kids scared of us because we are pumping it up harder each day. You will pump it up someday and you will be big like me, right?
Yeah, you're a big guy.
Yes, he knows it because he admires me. And I admire you too.
Good job.
He is crushing my hand. You are superhuman. Let's go pump the hoops. Pump the ball into the hoop.
Yeah.
Even though you have a girly ball, pump it.
With my such great strength, I shall shoot the ball into the basket.
I will move out of his way because I am big and large and he will never see the hoop with me in the way. He is so superhuman, the ball flew way over the hoop. Hans, you must control your super strength pompitudeness.
There you go, big guy.
Thank you.
Hans will try again. Watch his superhuman strength.
Make it.
Pump it. He
tried very hard, but he missed. We are out of practice because our muscles are full of lactic pompitude acid.
Now, Franz, you must shoot the basketball.
You hold the mic while I shoot the hoop.
Watch. Oh, Franz, as the basketball talent of the family. Shoot it again, Franz. Shoot it harder. You must shoot. Watch Franz with incredible hoopitude. Yes, a new Czechoslovakian record. Two baskets, one afternoon.
Now my friend Hans will demonstrate his basketball skill and prowess.
Observe as I have demonstrated a 360 layup.
And for those of you watching this, we are ad-libbing this, and I am putting Hans on the spot, and he doesn't even know it.
I must advise our viewers with less pompitude not to try this at home.
We are big and strong, so do take his advice.
Oh, that was good enough. That was good enough, though, Hans. I still love you.
We must cut this scene before it gets out of hand. Yeah. Hans and Franz telling you that he is Hans.
And I am Franz.
No, you are Hans.
I am Hans and you are Franz.
And we are here to pump
you up.
Thank you.
poor guy. This will do it.
Johnny.
Johnny?
Yeah.
What you reading here, Johnny?
This is a dictionary. I mean the dictionary. I'm reading all the words in the dictionary.
That's good, Johnny. That's good. Well, Johnny, what do you do, Johnny? Don't be afraid. I won't hurt you.
I'm a student here.
Student?
I'm also a tour guide here.
You're a tour guide.
I'm a really good tour guide.
A tour guide?
I do it a lot.
Do you get a lot of people with that?
Do I get a lot of people?
Do you get a lot of people with that?
Well, let me see. Like, last week, I got 68 people. 68 people in 1 week is pretty good, you know. I toured a lot. I showed them the college.
That's good.
You know, they like me.
That's good.
Their parents really like me.
Good.
The girls don't like me.
Well,
but their parents really like me.
Well, Johnny, would you like to come to work for me?
Work for you? You want me to work for you?
I need someone to help me work.
Need somebody, huh? What kind of work?
I'm kind of a doctor. Kind of. And I need an assistant to help me work.
Don't worry,
Johnny.
What are you doing?
Don't worry.
What are you doing?
Don't worry.
I'm Johnny Marzetti, tour guide. Now I have to give a tour of the Simpsons. Mommy, daddy, daughter, son, specimens.
Well, how many people are in there?
About
250.
Wow.
256. One of the newer. It's one of the nicer ones on campus.
Do men live here or do women live here?
Oh, co-ed. It's co-ed by room.
Visiting hours?
No, there's no visiting hours. It's co-ed. Men and women live together. Let's all get inside.
Women!
Come along, Noah.
Damn, I'm pissed, man.
Wow.
So wait, I know what matters. I saw that smoking. Is there no smoking in the dorms then? So smoking is banned by the students, is that right?
Smoking is not allowed. Some people do it, though, I have to be honest with you. So
wow, look at
let's
this
come
guy.
Along.
What's this for, man? What's this? What does it do?
No, don't touch that.
Come on.
There's a fire alarm. Don't you want to touch that? Mm-hmm. All right, we're going up the
stairs
now. I
understand that Oberlin has an agreement with Marriott. Did Marriott build this building for them?
No, I don't think so. I really don't know.
It looks a lot like some of the Marriott.
I'm just a tour guide.
It looks like amoebas or protozoans or something.
No, it's replicating chromatids. Don't you know anything?
What a bunch of geeks.
I can't believe
it. Oh, my God.
Why don't we take the elevator?
Any questions on the tour right now about classes or things like that?
I got a question.
Is that elevator safety inspected?
Yes, it is. Every quarter.
Okay.
I got a personal
Mr. Simpson.
Samson, I told you my name is Samson.
It's co-ed by room, so there's men and women on both floors everywhere, both rooms.
Aren't there any dorms that are all single sex, like all male? I mean,
no, not this college.
This place is so confusing. It looks just like the first one.
This is our third floor TV lounge. TV here, of course, for
our lesbians. It's like a maze around here.
It's such a large dorm, we should have another TV, however it was stolen. It's really unfortunate.
Really?
Is there a lot of theft that goes on campus?
Is it safe?
MTV, man!
Alright, this is a kitchen up here as well. Pencil sharpeners for your convenience.
Oh, you'll like that.
There's a fridge here as well. Many food items.
Another thing about thefts, I don't think this is this school safe? I mean, have you had things stolen?
I assure you it's safe. There's occasional theft here and there.
Occasional theft? I don't know about this. I mean, I'm a little bit concerned.
I'm very
sensitive.
About. I think
wait,
you're concerned
about thefts.
It's not that bad though.
It smells
gross!
Hey, what's that big martini in the corner?
Why there's so many lounges?
There's a lounge at the end of every floor so people can get together and have sex.
Do people smoke pot? Sex? What do you mean?
I'm just kidding, Mr. Sampson. Or Simpson. Sorry.
Sampson.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Does the college supply beer?
No, there's no beer supplied by the college. You just have to get it.
What's the drinking age in Ohio?
There's no drinking age. Everybody drinks
no
here.
No drinking age? That sounds good.
Who enforces the college?
Can we have fireworks?
Fireworks are not allowed.
Do people urinate on the floor?
People do all the time. It's really disgusting. Let's go down here real quick.
Dad, I'm out of pens, man.
Boy, these are small holidays. This is the neatest wallpaper!
It's not wallpaper, sis. That's special sound-absorbing material. That's why the rooms are so quiet.
Yeah, that's a good question. Are the rooms quiet?
You don't know what you're talking about.
I think so.
I still live here again. Yeah, I can't seem to leave this place.
Do all the doors look the same?
Is
I
don't
know.
Typical student's room. Let's take a look at a typical student.
John
here.
And Willie.
There he is now. He's studying right now. Studying hard.
Excuse me. Can we see your room?
Hi there. Can we see your room?
Come on,
it's a typical Oberlin student.
I have a gun.
You have a gun? Oh, he's just kidding. He really doesn't. How you doing, John?
It's 2 o'clock.
Studying again, I see.
Back plus.
He's just studying very hard in his room. Very good student here.
But what is on the ceiling?
He's required to have his own Snoopy dog.
So. Where's your woman?
There you go. All right, there. That's a typical student, so.
Is this a fire
hazard? Oh, yeah.
Sure. Do the students get supplied with computers when they come here?
No, that's his own. About 35% of the students here have their own computers. There's enough down the street, sir.
Are all the students that ugly?
35%.
I think we've seen enough here. Let's leave him to his studying. He's trying to work very hard.
No,
good luck, John, on that term paper. We'll see you, John. Good luck on that. See, you're looking at the doors and stuff.
Are they also small like that? They're like little mouse holes in there.
Well, I think they're decent size. I don't know. I don't know how long you plan on staying.
I've heard rumors about, the co-ed things that go on here, like co-ed bathrooms. Is that really true, or is that just a rumor?
What things have you heard? Go on. It's pretty safe, actually.
I've heard about
some. You don't really want to walk on those, honey. That's not great.
Oh,
take care of your dog.
What are those for?
Why don't you just get back with your brother, okay?
Yeah.
Aw, man, who's going to college? You or us?
Right, here's a typical vending machine. We have this nice vending area with lovely assorted candies.
Oh, my God! This is a pretty cool door, huh?
Papa Roth, there's rubbers.
What?
There are condoms in there. Does that mean you...
I don't put anything in the machine. I just,
Does that mean that Oberlin College...
Right next to the popcorn. Yeah.
Supports, like, fornication?
We don't really support anything outright. It's just that they're there for...
Free books and clothes.
I don't think he's going to use
video.
There's
a display about sex right over there. You're
inundating
these students with sex. I can't believe you.
It's like he could stand to use something. make our way out now.
A lot of Pez.
After we've seen our tour? Anybody? Mr. Simpson?
Simpson?
I'm sorry, sorry about it. Well, I have one, if nobody else has one. No, I like your shirt there. Where'd you get it?
The store.
What's it say on it?
Princeton sucks.
And what's on the back? Ah, very funny, very funny. Ah, God, you're never gonna go here. Okay, everybody, so we're gonna finish the tour.
Will you just be quiet?
We've got a few more things to do.
I'm sure.
Wow, it seems like this whole place is fashion coordinated, you know, like the carpet and the woodwork.
It's quite nice.
They always do that here at
That's
home.
What I want to be, a fashion coordinator. That's why I'm going over.
Alright, there's one more thing I gotta show you on the tour here. One more thing I have to show you all. There's a special room here on campus. Come along, Mr. Simpson.
Samson!
I'm sorry, Samson. It won't matter very much anymore. Come along. Let's go in here. Come along, Mr. Simpson. Go in there!
Samson!
No, come on, go in there!
Hey, what are you doing to my mom? What are you doing to my mom?
Specimens. Drink more methyl ethyl wham bam. Crunchy cod, that's what they are. They don't know it yet. You're all crunchy cod.
This is what I need. I can't believe I had to have that nerd work for me. But he'll get me the specimens I need.
Dr. Frankenstein!
What?
I got my specimens for you on the tours.
Just wait a minute. Okay. You got the specimens.
I got them for you.
What are you reading? What is this?
This is a sociology book I'm reading.
Sociology is not even a real science!
Oh. Well, I like it.
Shut up. Why are you looking at me like that, you nerd?
What are you doing?
What?
What are these? What is
don't
this?
Don't touch that!
What is it, huh?
Don't! Ah! Sit down and don't touch anything!
What is it all?
These are the jewels
What are you
that
doing?
I made.
What are you doing?
These are jewels that I made to help me make the perfect being.
Perfect being?
This
wow.
is working. I need to give him more of the drug.
More it's drugs? More drugs for me?
Swallow
it. Oh, I got the specimens you wanted, Dr. Frankenset.
Got the specimens?
They are in the closet. How many will you need today?
We should be working with two today. Stand up. We should now go. What's this? What's this? Let's go get the specimens. Hurry up! Alright, now! We need some specimens.
Specimens? I'll get them. They're in here. I put them in here, I remember. Yeah.
Now go in there and bring me out one specimen.
Okay.
Hurry up, fool.
I need a specimen. Hurry up!
Put it out!
I got this one.
I've got a vacuum!
Get in there and back! Take it out!
Weird.
What's this? What are you doing?
Ow.
He drug himself, but a nerd. That works for me. What's that? Stand over here. What do we do with him? Let's bring him back. I'll close the door.
Get the door closed.
All right, where are we going? Where are we going?
Bring them to my workroom.
All right, come on, geeks.
Let's go.
Oh, let's go this way.
Festive hands, crunchy cut. Yeah.
Johnny?
Yeah?
What's this on your shirt, Johnny?
Geez,
y'all.
mistake, but it was not mine.
What are you gonna do?
You brought me the wrong specimens.
What are you gonna do? You don't got any more specimens, Dr. Frankenstein.
But Johnny, I do have another specimen.
Where? You want me to go get him?
You already have, Johnny.
Thank you. Maybe I should call Evelyn. But first, I think I'll take his wallet. I need something for my troubles. Be back with an ambulance real quick. Bye.
Something in my drink.
Well, can you stand on your feet?
I'll try.
You act a little bit like a nerd, you know.
Thanks.
You got an ambulance waiting out here.
Oh, that'd be good.
You still filming? You okay?
Pulse. 120/70.
Come back.
jersey ring calls me daily and nightly.
Will you study hard?
Yo, I hope so. If Seth doesn't drag me down to the scope. Itchy, so I'll do a funny dance. Dance, come with Stevenson. The fucking goop is called Princey Cobb, but it looks like shit. If tuition gets higher, yo, I'll transfer. But for now, I still have a chance for...
Look at me! I can't live like this. I can't live like this now. This is it. With this new formula. I will become the perfect being.
Oh.
perfect. Yeah, I'm perfect. And I don't need no drugs. And I don't need no fancy clothes or some hype attitude to be perfect. I just gotta be me. And if you wanna be perfect, just be you.
Word.
Thank you.